Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an RX3i analog output card. I have here an IC695ALG704. This is a 4-channel current or voltage. It's capable of negative 10 volts DC to positive 10 volts DC maximum range, and measured in milliamps current, 0 to 20 milliamps or 0 to 20 milliamps plus DC. Okay, again, it's 4 channels. A couple things that I wanted to point out that you see in front of you. First is the ALG module itself. Module OK light is blinking green. That's good. You need to make sure that you at least have a light on. If you don't have a light on when you plug it in and everything's powered up properly and it's secured to the chassis, then there's likely that there's an issue with the unit and it will need replacement or repair. Okay. The other two lights is field status that has to do with an external power source and the terminal block. It's currently red. Now, this lever needs to be in the uprightmost position in order for the terminal block to be attached securely to the ALG card. All right, when that turns green and you've got this into the uprightmost position, that means that your connection has been made. Okay. Now my field status is orange, telling me that it detects the terminal block, but it doesn't detect the power it needs to power up the module and give us output values. Now on screw number 18, bottom left hand corner, I've got my negative lead from a 24 volt DC power supply. And my terminal number 36, bottom hand right terminal, has the positive lead from my 24 volt DC power supply. So I'm going to power that up, and you'll note that my field status has changed to green, okay? So this is exactly what you guys should have going into the test, is a light pattern that looks like this. If you don't, then it's likely that it's unable to take the power of the 24 volt DC because there's an issue with the card, or if you don't have a module OK light or any of these lights are not on, then it's immediately a failed card, okay? Now, next thing I want to do once I've got that on and secured and powered up is go to my software. I'm using Proficy Machine Edition. I have a new blank file. And the first thing I want to do in that file is go to Navigator Bar under Project, Hardware Configuration, and make sure I put the same configuration in this rack number 0 as I just showed you. So I happen to be using a 7-slot rack, CHS007. You can follow this test using a 012 or a 016 is fine. My power supply is using slots numbers 0 and 1, and my processor is using slots 2 and 3, leaving me with the next available slot of 4. Okay. Now you guys can double click on slot 4 or right click, add module, analog output tab, and we're looking for an IC695ALG704. Now, here's something that you guys are going to need to note. There's some configuration is required. Alright, some settings. The first thing that you want to do is just take note that the reference address starts on percent analog output AQ 00001. When we go to the reference table, that's going to become important. I'll show you what that means. Now, also very important, our output reference length is 8. Okay, that's going to mean that when we get to the reference table, every other reference address is going to be the reference address that we're going to need to use for all 4 channels. Okay, so then we'll be using 1, 3, 5, and 7, and I'll show you what that means when we get to that point. The other settings we have to be concerned with is our channels. So we'll go to channel 1, and we're going to go from our disabled circuit to a range of voltage or current, and the range that it automatically goes to, the default range is negative 10 volts DC to positive 10 volt DC. That's fine. We'll start there. Our channel value format, we're going to use 16-bit integer, and you'll notice that our maximum scale values are 10,000 or negative 10,000 if we want negative voltage. Okay, same thing. Enable the channel, give it 16-bit integer. Here's our scaling, 10,000 maximum. enable, 16-bit, note the scaling. That's the same for all channels. Okay. Now, once that's done, we want to configure it. We want to download it. So we're going to go to the lightning bolt icon and connect up to our processor. And once we've made connection, we're going to hit the green handprint, which toggles us to online mode. Okay, stop here for a second. Follow my arrow. Note the status of the processor in this bottom portion here. This information is it's in programmer mode. The outputs are stopped and disabled. The configuration is not equal and the logic is not equal. According to the processor, it's not equal because the processor was handling a different task before we've asked it to test this analog card. So it's technically faulted. What we do here is go to target, online commands, clear, and we only want to clear those faults that we've created, controller fault table and IO fault table, and hit OK. Again, you're going to get hung up if you don't do this before you download, so make sure that you've done that. Now we're ready to download and run, so we're going to hit download and start. And the first thing it's going to want to ask us is, what exactly do we want to download to the controller? And in this particular case, hardware configuration and motion and logic. We don't need to write anything to permanent flash memory or force any initial values. This is a really simple test. We're just going to manually put in values and test them. Okay. Now, while that's downloading, another tool I wanted to mention that I'm going to be using, I have here a multimeter. It happens to be a Fluke multimeter. You guys can use whatever you want as long as it measures voltage DC up to and down to 10 volts DC. And it's also going to test our milliamp in DC. Okay. Now, the download will only take a minute. And once it's done, it's going to allow us to turn on the outputs like so. Okay. Your processor should be in run mode at this point once you've okayed the turning on or enabling the outputs. If your processor is not in run mode at this point, you may want to take a look at your status, make sure your configuration and your logic is equal, you haven't left anything out. Or you can open up the battery door on the CPU and check to make sure that the position of the switch is in the far right hand side, which is enabling the outputs, putting it in run mode. Once you are in run mode, go back to your navigator bar and drag that down, and you want to expand, if you haven't already, your default tables. Go to analog output. Now, as we mentioned before, two very important things. Go to settings. Your reference address is 00001 or mine is. Just note what your reference address is if yours happens to be different. And that the length is 8. So what that means is I'm going to go in here. I'm going to show you guys. My channel 1 is analog output 00001. Maximum value is 10,000. Now we're going to skip 1 and go to 3. I'm going to skip 1 and go to 5. Notice I'm putting 10,000 and we're going to skip 1 and go to 7. Now, you'll notice that these channels cover, if you go from 8 to 1, they cover all 8 of the total length. Okay, again, take a look. Output reference length is 8. So we're going to use every other output. If you guys, for some reason, do 1, 2, 3, and 4, you're going to miss half of your channels. Okay, two of the channels will appear like they're not working. That doesn't mean that they're broken. It just means that you've put it in the wrong area. Okay. So again, I'm in run mode. I've got values that are set. And I want to probe these terminals. Now, the way these terminals are set up is, these channels are set up on the terminals, is that there's 3 screws per channel. The outermost two screws are for voltage, and the inner lowermost screws or terminals are for measuring milliamp. All right. So I'm going to place my negative lead, my negative probe on number 21, and my positive probe on number 19, and I'm looking for a value of 10 volts. Okay, and I have that perfectly. And then similarly, we're going to jump over to channel number 2, positive lead on number 1, negative lead on number 3, okay, 10 volts. And that's good. Now I know that the channel's active. But what I want to do at this point is I want to cut that value in Proficy Machine Edition in half, 5,000. I'm going to just do it for the first couple channels just to give you guys a taste of how to check range and resolution. And here's, this is important. Now I've got a solid value of 5 volts. All right, it's not moving up or down. It's not fluctuating. I have a solid value of 5 volts on both channels. All right, we'll take that one step further just for example. And I'm going to drop those two values to 2500. And of course, the value should be cut in half by my voltage, and it is 2.5 volts. All right, so we've seen 10 volts, we've seen 5 volts, we've seen 2.5 volts. It responds perfectly. So what you would look for in this particular case is that if you drop down to a value of 5,000 in Proficy Machine Edition, then you should get a voltage of 5 volts. If for some reason it's still reading 10 volts, that's a failed circuit. If you drop it down to 2,500, still reading 10 volts. Same thing, failed circuit. All right, so note that sometimes these analog cards fail in the state of full value, is what we actually commonly see here. All right. So now that we've tested voltage, we're gonna stop the controller. We're gonna go into our ALG704 tab, channel 1, and we're going to bring it to 0 to 20 milliamps is fine. Note that our scale values have changed. Our maximum value is 20,000. All right, well, I'm going to show you when that's going to become important. 0 to 20 milliamps, scale 20,000. 0 to 20 milliamps, same thing. Okay, 20,000 is our maximum value. Down below again, we've changed what we're asking the card and the processor to do, so our configuration has become, again, not equal. We're faulted. Go to target, online commands, clear, and clear those faults. Controller fault table, IO fault table. Bottom two selections and select yes. And then we're gonna download and run that configuration. The same thing when it asks us what we want to download. That's easy. It's the top two selections, configuration and motion and logic. And then we'll carry on. Okay, same as before. Yes. And then it'll go through the rest of its downloading process. Now, at this time, you want to switch over your multimeter to reading milliamps in DC, okay? Now typically I could speak for Fluke, a milliamp reading's default setting is AC, so make sure that you're reading DC, because if you try to use AC, you're not gonna get any information that's useful, okay? And again, it doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with it. Another thing to keep in mind on this terminal block is that if the screws are in the outwardmost position on the terminals, meaning that they're loose, that typically would prohibit you from getting any kind of value on that channel. All right, what you could do in that case is you could stick the probe inside of where the wires would go, or you could simply just tighten down the screw. All right. So go back to our analog output table, and I'm just going to work with the first two channels for an example for you guys. Channel 1 is on analog output 00001. Channel 2 is on analog output 00003, not 2. Please keep that in mind. I'm going to go back here for a second to show you guys settings. We still have that reference length of 8. So bear that in mind. And we're doing every other channel. All right? Don't want you guys to get any false readings. So I'm going to attach my probes. I'm looking for a value of, you know, between 20 and 21 milliamps. Okay. I'm going to show you that. My negative lead is attached to terminal number 21, positive lead 20. Again, it's the bottom nearest most screws on that channel. Okay, 21 milliamps. And 21 milliamps on our output number 2. Now let's check range and resolution. Let's see if we can cut that number in half. And we should have a value of somewhere in the neighborhood of 11 milliamps. Okay, bottom two most screws, 21 and 20. This is channel 1. 11 milliamps, that's perfect. 11 milliamps, perfect. Please note also, I don't have any fluctuation. Okay, I don't have any channels that are going up and down and up and down and kind of all over the place. If it's not stable, then the circuit's broken. It's no good. You need to be able to put in a value that can stay solid, constant, and stable. It's very important. All right, and that's how you can detect if it's a broken card. So check for range and resolution. Make sure it can go up and down. You know, especially with milliamp, if you put in a value of 20,000 and you get 21 milliamps, that's great. It's a working circuit so far. If you put in half that value, it should cut in half. If it's stuck at full value, it's a failed card. It's a failed channel. It's a failed card. Okay. IC695ALG704 is a card that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.